Hey there, Kyepha here, and I hope you're doing well today. This week I have a special video that has been requested many times since I made my How to Make a Fakemon video back in 2018. So without further ado, here is an artwork tutorial for drawing in the latest Pokemon art style. For this guide, I'll be drawing Kokobi, mostly because it needs an updated artwork, being the mascot and all, but it's also the easiest of my Fakemon to draw, so if you want to use Kokobi as a creature to test your new skills on, then go ahead. This drawing took me about 50 minutes to complete, and I used paint tool Sai. Step 1. Sketching. So this step is pretty straightforward. All you need to do is complete a refined sketch of your creature. I like to start off pretty rough and then refine some details as I'm building the drawing. You can see here I'm making a few decisions about scale, positions, and so forth. As you draw more and more, this decision making process becomes fairly automatic, but when you're starting out it can be mentally draining, so be sure to take breaks when you need them. Step 2. Lining. When doing Pokemon art, I usually go with a rougher brush that looks more like a grainy pencil or a blotchy paintbrush. It gives it that roughish homemade style that Pokemon are really well known for. Going for thick lines is better than going for thin lines. You don't want to overdo it. I find working on a 2000 by 2000 pixel canvas with size 4-7 brushes works best. If you're having trouble finding an accurate brush, then there are many free brush settings you can find online. Just search on Google for something like Sugimori brush and then the program you're using. So in my case, I would search for Sugimori brush Sai. Step 3. Color. After your line work is fully complete, in a new layer underneath the line art layer, you can either start to draw in the color or use the magic wand tool to select areas of your creature that you'd like to color. Sometimes you'll have to do both depending on how you did your line art. I prefer to use the magic wand as often as I can because it saves a lot of time and ends up being a lot more precise and within the lines. Step 4. Shading and highlighting. We're almost done. Again, in a new layer, this time in between the lines and the color layers, you want to start blocking in where the shading is going to go. I use a dark blue color to do this. I then keep the shading oblique while I do a shaving technique, which is essential to use when doing the Pokemon art style. Try to shave on a mid-opacity brush with little pressure. Do this on every edge and try to keep the shaved area on the same thickness. Not too thick that it looks off and not too thin that you can't see it. Then, once you're done, you can erase some shade to let some light bleed in and give it three dimensionality. After everything is looking how you want it, change the opacity of the layer to anywhere between 30-45%. It will vary depending on the color of the creature. Light colors don't need deep shading like darker colors would. With highlighting, you want to do pretty much the same. Try to experiment a bit with it. Make sure you're doing this on a separate layer from the shading and don't overlap the two. With highlighting, you want to work with white or light yellow. It can be tricky getting it to look official. There are two methods. The classic way is to draw your highlighted areas and then with a low opacity brush, erase it with a low pressure feathery approach, like you're using a paintbrush. This will create that light, cloudy effect that a lot of classic Pokemon art has. For the newer art, it works very much the same as shading. Just shave the highlight and be sure to keep it the same thickness and not too thick or thin. Afterwards, lower the opacity of the layer down to about 20-30% on an overlay setting. This is around the perfect opacity for a highlight, and having it on an opacity setting will bring in the color more. Final step, refining. You can do quite a bit in this stage to finish off your drawing. I like to color some loose ends of the lines a bit and adding some texture, which you can easily do in a new layer by selecting all of the parts you want textured and then using a textural brush to fill it in. Once you're done, make the layer an opacity of 2-10%. I'm also sure to check that any white parts are filled in and not transparent, and that I didn't forget to color or shade anything. Once all of the refining is done, it's ready to publish. I hope this tutorial slash guide helped you make your very own Pokemon styled artwork. If you use this guide to make some new art, then please show me. I'd love to see what you come up with. You can find me on Twitter and DeviantArt, both at KyephaLife. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to see even more Pokemon and Fakemon content. Also, if you're interested in any behind the scenes stuff or early artwork by me, then check out my Patreon, which I'll link below with everything else. Thank you again, and I'll see you guys in a week. Bye!